Welcome to the graduation ceremony for the class of 2020 at Freeburg Community High School. My name is Principal Jill Jung, and it has been an honor and a privilege to work with each and every one of you throughout your high school years. I remember the nervous excitement when you showed up to freshman orientation 4 years ago. There were questions and comments like, am I going to remember what class to go to? Are any of my friends going to be in my lunch hour? What are my teachers going to be like? The worries quickly faded after your first week. You were able to navigate the hallways, handle the homework, find a lunch table, and become friends with students you had never gone to school with previously. You also found out that your teachers were not as scary as you thought. They were strong, outgoing, and ready to help you. You also found out that they had a sense of humor when you saw them perform the homecoming skits. You showed up on your first day as kids at Freeburg High School, and after 4 years, you're going to leave as adults. There are so many experiences that you will never forget. When we started school last fall, none of us could have envisioned a spring or a graduation such as this. The finish to your senior year and graduation may look different, but your achievement and successes have never been more important. Your resilience, creativity, and transition to becoming more independent are skills that will carry you through life. As time passes, the events of this time will be historical. However, as you graduate and leave Freeburg, your story will still develop. Thank you for being such an awesome class of seniors. I wish you the very best in all that you do and look forward to all of your accomplishments. Thank you to all the teachers, parents and family members, the administration, the school board, and the community for all the support that you have given these students throughout their high school years. You have been instrumental in shaping their lives. They are a strong group of young adults to be proud of. Next in the program, we are going to hear from our class valedictorians. The overall theme today is 2020, a Freeburg Midget Odyssey. Each speaker will present a piece of the story. Congratulations to the class of 2020. I am so proud of you. Thank you.
Hi, everyone, and congratulations. It's crazy to think how far we've come since freshman year and how much we've learned. We've learned a lot in the classroom. Math, science, English, geography, how to write a paragraph, and how to solve an equation. But for as much as we've learned from the textbooks, we've learned even more outside of it. We've learned how to work as groups, how to argue, how to compromise, how it feels to win and to lose, and to keep going at it anyway. We've better learned to express ourselves, to be ourselves, to find what we want and go for it. We've learned the confidence that will allow us to walk out into the world, trusting in our ability to thrive. But most importantly, we've learned none of this alone. We learned we are not alone. Every single one of us standing at this point is impressive, yes, but our achievements are not singular. The support, guidance, and love from our teachers, our families, our administration, and each other has been there every step of the way, pushing us forward and onward. So, going onward, carry with you the knowledge that you are not alone. It isn't just reassurance that you will always have people there to help you and root for you in all that is to come, but it's a promise you make as well, to do the same for those around you. We're stronger together. Every time we lift someone else up, we lift ourselves up too. So thank you, Class of 2020, for lifting me up. And know that FCHS will always do the same for you.
As a valedictorian for the Class of 2020, I was asked to prepare a speech. The topic of choice for my speech is taking risks. This is a scary aspect of life, but a part that cannot be avoided. We take risks every day, whether it is the risk of telling the person you like how you really feel, picking a college or career field, or moving away from home to follow your dreams. Our lives are full of taking risks. Risk-taking provides us with valuable life lessons regardless of whether or not it works out in our favor. One does not live without taking risks. They are the only way for us to move forward in this crazy thing we call life. As Mark Twain once said, 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. As we move on to the next chapter of our lives, I hope that you are not afraid to take risks. After all, it is much better to take a risk and fail than to do nothing and have regrets. We are all capable of great things if we just take the risks and the steps to achieve our goals. Our lives can be amazing. Now it is time for us all to take the next step in our lives and move forward. Take those risks. Live your life. Live your dreams. Thank you to each and every person who helped us along the way. Thank you, Senior Class of 2020, for an amazing 4 years of high school, and I wish you all well with each risk you take in the future.
Part of the journey is the end. Tony Stark. Today, a four-year journey ends, and a new one begins. As we enter into the next phase of our lives, it's not going to be easy. Whether you're going to college, enlisting into the military, or going into the workforce, it's going to be an uphill battle. At some point, life is going to be harder than it's ever been, and you are going to convince yourself that you made the wrong decision. It is at those times that you must remember three simple words: never give up. All of us graduating today have different people and beliefs that help get us through difficult times. For many of us, that will be our religion, our family, and our friends. When we are in difficult times, it is most important to look around and realize that there are people who believe in you, and that you can accomplish your hopes and dreams, no matter how difficult they may seem. When your college classes are getting harder and harder, never give up. When your future boss gives you a seemingly impossible deadline, never give up. When you're playing pickup basketball and are 0-for-6 from the field, never give up. The last thought I want to leave with you today is a quote from the movie Sing. The good thing about hitting rock bottom, there's only one way to go, and that's up. To all the students, teachers, and everyone who has made the last 4 years the best I could ask for, thank you. Good luck, everyone, and may the force be with you.
Hey, FCHS Class of 2020. I know this year has looked a little bit different, and it's ending in a way that none of us could have expected. But I would like to congratulate all of you on making it through this wild journey and graduating together as the Class of 2020. Now, I know you've all played Tetris. It was definitely one of everyone's favorite things to do freshman year, before all of our games got blocked and we had to focus on schoolwork. So this analogy will be simple. You've played Tetris, you know how it works. When you fit in, you disappear. I don't think there's a more perfect analogy for being yourself. If we all sit and try to fit into whatever mold society has created for us, we will never be our own person. We will simply disappear in the crowd. High school was a little bit different, though. If you try to fit in, you could lose yourself. But if you don't, you get lost in the crowd. Luckily for us, those times have passed. Don't get me wrong, high school was an amazing experience. But now it's our time to shine. We aren't defined by the walls of FCHS. We can do whatever we set our minds to and truly be ourselves in the process. We are all a little bit weird in our own way, but that's how it's supposed to be. We shouldn't strive to fit the mold. Do what you love and love what you do. Find your passion and pursue it wholeheartedly. You will find yourself and you will find your people. Thank you, Freebird Class of 2020, for making my 4 years here nothing short of an interesting ride. You have all made an impact on my high school experience, whether you know it or not, and I can't wait to see what all of you do in the future. We always knew our class was going to be special, so let's continue that outside the walls of FCHS. Go out and find your place in this world, but above all else, find yourself, be yourself, and love yourself.
I'd like to start by congratulating all of us on working so hard these past 4 years to get here. However, instead of looking back on the last 4 years, I'd like to focus on how successful we are going to be in the future. In our previous school years, the majority of us have lived in and embraced our small town communities. Now, we are able to go off on our different paths and start the next chapter of our lives while still holding tight to our small town values. There is no other moment like this for us. We are able to start over. We can be whoever and whatever we want, wherever we want. Whether you're going to a large university, a small college, or straight into the workforce, this is the beginning of the rest of our lives. There is nothing holding us back, and we need to make the most of this opportunity. This is our time. Use this chance to chase your biggest dreams or complete your most difficult goals. As Walt Disney once said, all of our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. While it is overwhelming to have this type of new freedom, we shouldn't be scared. We should be excited and determined. No matter who you have been in the past, it doesn't matter. Now, you can be anyone you want to be. Thank you so much for giving me the best high school experience I could ever ask for, and I will miss each and every single one of you. Have a great summer, and I wish you the best of luck in all of your future endeavors. I cannot wait to see what the class of 2020 achieves. Go Midgets!
Congratulations, my fellow graduates. We did it. These past 4 years have gone by so quickly. We've laughed, we've cried, we've celebrated. And unique to us this year, we were isolated and quarantined, but our time at Freeburg has come to an end. I would like for you to think about those who have made your journey successful. Think about your family, your friends, your teachers, and your community who have all played a role in helping us being successful. I would like for you to take some time this summer and throughout the rest of your life and to reflect and ask, how can I give back? There is not one correct answer. We are the class of 2020. We are intelligent, we are creative, we are resourceful, and we are determined enough to come up with our own way to give back to our families, our friends, our teachers, and our communities. Whether it's your time, your talent, or your treasure, take the step up and give back to those who have helped you. To my fellow graduates, good luck on whichever path you choose to follow next. Goodbye, and congratulations, class of 2020.
As valedictorian, I was asked to give a speech on the topic of my choice, and I chose the topic lifelong friends. During our 4 years at Freeburg, we have made a lot of friends, many of which we will treasure for the rest of our lives. You see, school is the place where you are meant to find lifelong friends. We've experienced a lifetime of similarities and faced each at the same age in our lives. We were born during the 9/11 era. We've lived through the same presidencies. Our molding years have all been done together. The friends that are made here are the ones who will always be by our side and always want what's best for us. These are the people who will always help us, instill confidence in us, inspire us to be stronger, or push us to newer intellectual heights. I've experienced this type of community at Freeburg Community High School. Together, we will remain lifelong friends, and even if we do not keep in touch, we'll have our memories of classes, competitions, sports, and events together to keep us united. No matter if we are 5,000 miles apart or still close, I'll always be there for you, willing to help. Thank you to the faculty, the staff, and to you, my classmates, for an amazing 4 years. I look forward to what's next in my life and witnessing what is next for each of you. I'll end this speech with a quote from Winnie the Pooh. If ever there is a tomorrow when we are not together, there is something you must always remember. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. But the most important thing is, even if we're apart, I'll always be with you. Goodbye, senior class of 2020.
Hello, Fever graduates. Congratulations on making it to this huge milestone in your life, even though it ended in a way that none of us could have ever imagined. Little do we know that March 13th would be the last day we parked in the senior lot, said hi to our teachers in their classrooms, or sat with our friends at the lunch tables. This pandemic has not only taken away the end of our senior year, but has also posed challenges we never expected to face. Undoubtedly, these challenges will only make us more prepared for bigger challenges in the future. Whether you plan on going to college or trade school, joining the military, or heading straight into the workforce, your time in and out of the classroom has taught you how to overcome any obstacle. Inevitably, the path ahead will not be easy. And like our virtual graduation ceremony today, it will not go completely as planned either. You may change your major, get turned down from your dream job, fail a test, or not meet a planned goal. At the time, these may seem like failures, but later on you will realize that they only served as encouragement to push you to do better and come back even stronger. Though the future is up in the air, I know you will all be ready to face any challenge that arises. Unlike other graduating classes, you have been forced to adapt to situations like e-learning, staying away from friends and family, taking care of a sibling, or working a job with strict safety guidelines. I know you will all do great things in the future. Just remember that facing a challenge can be difficult at times, but the rewards at the end are so worth it. Congratulations again, Freebird Class of 2020, and go Midgets!
Thank you, students, for the wonderful and inspirational speeches. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would also like to take this opportunity and thank you for viewing FCH's first and hopefully last virtual commencement ceremony today. Hopefully, you are sitting with your family and your graduate viewing this video together. Parents and families, please know that your support for your student means a great deal to the faculty, staff, administration, Board of Education, and especially the graduates of the class of 2020. No one could have imagined that the school year would end the way it has. While we are hoping that we will be able to come together later this summer, I hope that our seniors and the families will be able to watch this video and try to remember all the sacrifices that each of you have made to get to the point you are in your lives. Good luck, stay safe, and let's move forward with the ceremony. At this time, I would like to recognize the district's Board of Education. These men and women work very hard to ensure that the district has the resources it needs to educate all of our students and to ensure that the district's mission is successfully fulfilled. The current board members are Ms. Justice Dickey, Student Advisory Member, Mr. Gary Henning, Mr. Mike Reynolds, Mrs. Angie Miller, Mr. Dennis Haas, Mrs. Victoria Staub, who is our board secretary, Mr. Dean Gauck, who is our board vice president, and Mr. Doug Pears, who is our board president. Board members, thank you for your leadership and support of the important activities of Freeburg Community High School. The work you do is difficult, but without it, this school and these students would not be successful in their endeavors, both here at FCHS and as they venture into the world outside our hallways. On behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration, I'd like to thank you for your diligent efforts improving FCHS and the services provided to our exceptional students. I am now honored to recognize and acknowledge the work of the district's outstanding building principals. Ms. Lori Crunk serves as our assistant principal, and Ms. Jung serves as our principal. Ms. Crunk and Ms. Jung work diligently to establish and maintain a positive learning environment here at FCHS. This task is difficult, but they do it very well. The students and teachers of FCHS know the positive influence and contribution they make every day. I thank them for their work and the crucial role they play in the lives of the district students. Mrs. Crunk and Mrs. Jung, thank you for the outstanding work you do and the positive influence you've had on the class of 2020. The students of the class of 2020 have had the distinct pleasure of working with a faculty that is abound with teachers who are creative, caring, and more than competent in maximizing learning of all students who attend FCHS. This was no more apparent than through these difficult times over the last few months of this school year. Faculty members, thank you for your dedicated efforts on behalf of the class of 2020. This year, FCHS is saying farewell to an outstanding teacher. Mr. Doug Haas, who is an alumni of FCHS, returned to teach and coach at FCHS in August of 2000, in year 2000. Mr. Haas taught industrial arts, has coached baseball, golf, and bowling. Thank you for your dedication to our students and staff for the last 20 years. Good luck in your retirement. It is now my pleasure to highlight some of the academic accomplishments of the class of 2020 and to recognize some outstanding individuals and their contributions to the work and mission of Freeburg Community High School. Membership of the National Honor Society represents academic performance at the very highest level and exhibit the following characteristics: service, leadership, character, and citizenship. The following graduates are members of the National Honor Society of the class of 2020: Jacob Blasdell, Kelsey Burrows, Brianna Chandler, Abby Collins, Emily Dermody, Ellie Eichenlaub, Isabel Eimer, Luke Irby, Olivia Fiedler, Leah Foster, Caroline Gagan, Morgan Gauck, Victoria Gravett, Lauren Engel, Jake Isaacs, Chloe Jansen, Megan Jester, Taylor Jester, Bridget King, Rebecca Leedy, Ireland Leshy, Grace Marlin, Drew McKillop, Cody Means, Maddie Mency, Anna Miller, Allison Meath, Christopher Patton, Corey Patton, Jessica Perot, Nolan Reinick, Abby Sinheinrich, Chloe Shanuel, Aiden Schlichting, Jessica Shepherd, Maggie Schultz, Lexi Smith, Tyler Stafko, Kylie Stevenson, Leah Thompson, Lindsay Wydell, Mackenzie Wydell, and Molly Wolf. The following students earned recognition through their academic excellence and high achievement on the ACT or SAT tests and are nationally recognized as presidential scholars: Jacob Blasdell, Abigail Collins, Ellie Eichenlaub, Olivia Fiedler, Caroline Gagan, Chloe Jansen, Bridget King, Ireland Leshy, Grace Marlin, Cody Means, Anna Miller, Jordan Murley, Allison Meath, James Oldhoft, Kyle Parker, Jessica Perot, Nolan Reinick, Aiden Schlichting, Margaret Schultz, Tyler Stafko, Adam Stein, and Molly Wolf. The state of Illinois annually awards the top 10% of each class from approved high schools as an Illinois State Scholar. Congratulations to the following students for earning the designation as Illinois State Scholar: Jacob Blasdell, Abigail Collins, Ellie Eichenlaub, Olivia Fiedler, Caroline Gagan, Chloe Jansen, Ireland Leshing, Grace Marlin, Andrew McKillop, Jordan Murley, Allison Meath, James Oldhate, Kyle Parker, Ainsley Parrish, Christopher Patton, Corey Patton, Jessica Perot, Nolan Reinick, Aiden Schlichting, Samuel Shevlin, Margaret Schultz, Tyler Stafko, Adam Stein, and Molly Wolf. Honors Night is held each spring to honor those students who have made an impact both in the classroom and in extracurricular activities. It is now my pleasure to announce the recipients of these departmental awards: the Frederick Douglass and Susan B. Anthony Award in Humanities and Social Studies Award goes to Anna Murley. The Bile Shalom Award goes to Anna Murley. The Biological Science Award goes to Ireland Leshy. Physical Sciences Award goes to Chloe Jansen. The Agricultural Sciences Award goes to Jesse Hodrick. The Art Department Award goes to Grace Shaw. The Yearbook Award goes to Olivia Proctor and Shelby Hansen. The Band Aaron Award goes to Cody Means. The Chorus Aaron Award goes to George McDonald. The Business and Computer Department Award goes to Leah Foster. The English Department Award goes to Allison Meath. And the Family and Consumer Science Department Award goes to Kylie Stevenson. The Industrial Technology Department Award goes to Alex Smith. The Drafting Award goes to George McDonald. The Student Growth Award goes to Elizabeth Volkamp. The Social Studies Department Award goes to Ellie Eichenlaub. The Girls Physical Education Department Award goes to Katie Houck. The Boys Physical Education Department Award goes to Riley Miller. Girls Weightlifting Award goes to Kelsey Burrows. Boys Weightlifting Award goes to Logan Chama. The Spanish Department Award goes to Jordan Murley. The Mathematics Department Award goes to Christopher Patton. The Freeburg FFA Alumni Scholarship goes to Jesse Hodrick. The John Philip Sousa Award goes to Allison Meath. The Freeburg Band Parents Association Scholarship goes to Allison Meath. And the Student Council Scholarship Award goes to Tyler Stafko. The Iron Midgets Awards are earned by students for having 4 years of perfect attendance. Each student will receive an Iron Midget statue made in our Industrial Arts Department. Due to the remote learning, those awards are not finished and will be distributed to students when in-person classes resume in the fall. Recipients for the 2020 Iron Midgets Award go to Emily Dermody, Braden Fiscus, Eli Hoover, Rebecca Leedy, Jack Parker, Nolan Reinick, and Chloe Shanuel. The following students are being honored for their accomplishments in extracurricular activities. The St. Louis Post-Dispatch Scholar Award goes to Caroline Gagan. The Brenda Boyer Dickerson Award goes to Lexi Smith. The Gary Hearn Award goes to McAllen Smith, Luke Irby, Kelsey Burrows, and Brianna Chandler. The Illinois Principals Leadership Award goes to Allison Meath and Luke Irby. And the Freeburg Community High School Citizenship Awards go to Ellie Eichenlaub and Chloe Jansen. The following students have applied and were awarded the following scholarships. The Turkey Hill Grange Scholarships go to Ellie Eichenlaub and Allison Meath. The Freeburg Chamber of Commerce Scholarships go to Nolan Reinick and Chloe Jansen. The Citizens Bank Scholarship goes to Nolan Reinick. The Orson and Fern Seibert Foundation Scholarship goes to Hannah Pixley. The Tamara Crow Memorial Scholarship goes to Bailey Hodrick. The Gordon Butcher Scholarship goes to Tyler Stafko. The Clyde Pruitt Memorial Scholarship goes to Kelsey Burrows. The L.W. Baumgarty Scholarship goes to Jordan Murley. The Eugene and Myrtle Sanders Memorial Scholarship goes to Abigail Collins. The Lowell Laddick Scholarship goes to Molly Wolf. The Otto B. Johnson Senior Memorial Scholarship goes to Abby Sennheinrich. And the Leroy E. and Farrell M. Bauer Scholarship go to Brianna Chandler and Aiden Schlichting. The Midget Athletic Booster Club Scholarships go to Chloe Shanuel, Chloe Jansen, Ellie Eichenlaub, Caroline Gagan, Joe Lugie, Aiden Schlichting, Tyler Stafko, and Samuel Zittel. The Andrew Lehman Memorial Scholarship Award goes to Jacob Blasdell. The Jennifer Reitzel Memorial Scholarship goes to Abby Sidheinrich. The Smithton Commercial Club Scholarships go to Lindsay Wydell, Mackenzie Wydell, Bailey Hodrick, Chloe Shanuel, and Daniel Walsh. The Rotary Vocational Scholarship goes to Dylan Schmidt. The Rotary Klassen Service Above Self Scholarship goes to Emily Dermody. The National Merit Scholarship goes to Ellie Eichemann. The St. Clair County Scholarship goes to Ellie Eichemann. And the Freeburg FFA Alumni Scholarship goes to Jesse Hodrick. Each year, FCHS recognizes members of the graduating class who have earned a cumulative grade point average of 4.5 on a 5.0 scale as cum laude graduates. The following graduates in the class of 2020 have achieved this honor: Macy Adams, Caden Chama, Brianna Chandler, Luke Irvy, Braden Fiscus, Dalton Fortier, Elizabeth Haas, Jessica Hartman, Bailey Hodrick, Catherine Hauck, Carly Kelly, William Lannert, George McDonald, Chelsea Meyer, Shay Nail, Tristan Oxford Monroe, Jack Parker, Kyle Parker, Cassidy Peters, Nolan Reinick, Josh Reeder, William Richardson, Jacob Rickert, Abby Sidheinrich, Alex Smith, Riley Touche, Lily Trentman, Elizabeth Volkamp, Molly Walters, Caitlin Williams, and Sam Zittel. In order to graduate with the distinction of magna cum laude, a student must enroll in a highly rigorous curriculum and have earned a cumulative grade point average of at least a 4.6 out of a 5-point scale. These students are Alex Aguirre, Nicholas Borja, Connor Crowell, Emily Dermody, Olivia Fiedler, Leah Foster, Peyton Gantz, Morgan Gauck, Jessica Hodrick, Eli Hoover, Lauren Engel, Jake Isaacs, Julia Key, Bridget King, Rebecca Leedy, Austin Lickenbrock, Joe Lugie, Grace Marlin, Brandon McClary, Andrew McKillop, Madison Mency, Anna Miller, Jordan Murley, Riley Miller, Kaylin Olson, Ainsley Parrish, Hannah Pixley, Chloe Shanuel, Ella Siebenberger, Jessica Shepherd, Alexandra Smith, Adam Stein, Kylie Stevenson, Leah Thompson, Claire Walker, Mackenzie Wydell, and Molly Wolf. Summa cum laude graduates have also enrolled in a highly rigorous course load while earning a cumulative grade point average of at least a 4.8 on a 5-point scale. Graduates earning this distinction are Jacob Blasdell, Kelsey Burrows, Abby Collins, Ellie Eichenlob, Isabella Eimer, Caroline Gagan, Gabrielle Garland, Victoria Gravett, Chloe Jansen, Megan Jester, Taylor Jester, Ireland Leshy, Cody Means, Allison Meath, James Oldhape, Christopher Patton, Corey Patton, Jessica Perot, Samantha Powers, Aiden Schlichting, Samuel Shevlin, Margaret Schultz, Tyler Stafko, Noah Stock, Daniel Walsh, and Lindsay Wydell. Congratulations to all the students for the honors they have earned, both in the classroom and in extracurricular activities. I am now honored to present the class of 2020 for graduation. As superintendent of Freeburg Community High School District 77, I hereby certify that each student participating in this commencement ceremony has met the requirements for graduation set by the State of Illinois, the Illinois State Board of Education, and the Freeburg Community High School District 77 Board of Education. On behalf of the faculty and administration, I recommend that each receive a diploma in recognition of their accomplishments. Now please enjoy the following video presentation of the class of 2020, highlighting each graduate's personal memories and honors earned through their 4 years at Freeburg Community High School.